Covered country lanes. People are busy with preparation, with expectation. Christmas is coming. As this busy Christmas season progresses, the nights become longer and the days become colder. But tonight, in this place, we celebrate warmth. We celebrate the light. Countless hours have been spent to bring you light. Lots and lots of lights. Flickering lights, flashing lights, lights breaking out into the darkness. In fact, tonight you're going to see over 60,000 lights, all choreographed to great music. And of course, we're very excited to present you this show. But we love this show for one reason and one reason alone. And that is because all this music and all these lights remind us of the one true light, the light of Jesus Christ our Lord. And let me interject something real quick. I get asked all the time from people, hey, is it okay if I take pictures or videos? And the answer is, of course, by all means. While you're celebrating the light with us tonight, feel free to take pictures and share the light on social media, Facebook, Twitter. Our final performance will be tomorrow morning at 10:30 a.m. And without any further ado, my friends, I invite you to sit back, relax, and help us celebrate the light together. winter wonderland indeed. In city parks and in homes all around this area, there are wonderlands of displays of light and music set up. Music is indeed in the air. Christmas is such a great time of year, a time to be with the ones you love, sharing so much joy and cheer. What a wonderful feeling, and what a joy it is to be together with you here tonight as we celebrate the light. You know, when Jesus was born, he brought together all sorts of people, ordinary shepherds from the hillsides, wealthy wise men from eastern lands, and many others, and he still brings people together even to this day. And so, my friends, what a pleasure it is, truly a pleasure, to see each and every one of you here tonight celebrating the light. And yet, even as we sit here tonight, we know that many people, perhaps some of us even in this room tonight, struggle with heartache, with betrayal, with loneliness, struggle with economic hardship or health problems. And in our world, there's war and oppression and violence, utter madness, it seems, everywhere that we turn. Or maybe you struggle to make it all happen, to meet the demands placed upon your time. And you struggle with, even if you can make it happen, whether it's even worth it to do it. Doubt, skepticism, cynicism, and mistrust all become thoughts in your mind. Brothers betray brothers, old, venerated, and trustworthy institutions fail. The 24-hour news cycle seems tiring, and nothing that we do seems right. And so in the midst of this joyous season, yet we skeptically ask, can there really be peace on earth? And in despair I bowed my head. There is no peace on earth, I said. But a voice calling out into the night challenges my despair, saying, Behold, the people walking in darkness have seen a great light. To those who live in a land of deep darkness, upon them a light has shined. These songs and these bells ring ever more loud and deep. God is not dead, nor doth he sleep. The wrong will fail, the right will prevail. With peace on earth, goodwill to men. And so if I had an opportunity tonight to walk around this very room and talk to people, I know for a fact that there'd be some of you who would testify to what it's like to walk in brokenness and darkness and despair. And you, maybe more than anyone else here tonight, knows the true meaning of Christmas because you know what it means for God to lift you up out of the darkness. We here are also witnesses to that light. That light is none other than the light of Jesus Christ our Lord. We ourselves were once lost, stumbling in the darkness. We were blind, but now we see. And so tonight, my friends, we celebrate, yes, we truly celebrate God's amazing grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound, made it safe. Thank you.
Hallelujah. The kingdom of this world has become the kingdom of our Lord and of his Christ, and he shall reign forever and ever. Amen. Yet this king did not come in a typical royal way. They found him asleep in a lowly animal stable, and people then did not fully understand all that his coming meant. The Bible says he looked ordinary. He possessed no splendid looks for us to see. He was born in Bethlehem, which was an ordinary town, on an ordinary night, much like tonight. But God, as he always does, takes ordinary things and makes the most extraordinary things out of them. So what a night it must have been when Christ was born, a most holy night indeed.